we actually decided to experiment a little bit with how we work. And we started with the new fashion narrative process as a residency. We invited 5 designers to co-curate the exhibition. And we literally invited them. They were here in Maastricht for 5 days. We gave them one assignment to think about a concept, to come up with a concept that can be used for the open call and it has its own curatorial point of view.
My name is Boris Kollar. I'm from Slovakia and I live in Netherlands for 10 years already. I design clothes still, but I also work for a theater as a dresser and I also have an interest with architecture because I come from an architecture family. So I still help curate the program of architectural festival with my parents.
My name is Jonathan Hope and I'm an artist and designer currently living in Amsterdam and I make clothes. So I not only design, but I also make and work in a variety of different fields from costume design to wearables to custom made clothing.
I'm Enzo, I'm 24. I'm from Paris originally. I studied graphic design and digital media for 2 years. And then I moved to Amsterdam. I work with fashion practices and visual arts with a big interest for fashion imagery. And I also do some critical writing about online media and the use of advertisement in the context of fashion advertisements.
My name is Chinouk. I'm a design researcher and critical fashion practitioner, which is a mouthful, but I research the crossover between fashion and digital culture with a focus on introducing digital literacy in fashion.
My name is Lotte. I'm 28 years old. I'm from Amsterdam. I identify as a woman. I'm a fashion designer, but also a performer, a stylist, a creative producer, and I'm interested in the way fashion transforms our society and the other way around.
I got an email all of a sudden out of the blue and basically just asking if I would be interested to join this open call.
I found out about the project through an email that Branko, one of the co-worker at FashionClash, sent to me.
So I applied to FashionClash because I really liked the way that the process of this residency was framed. I liked the idea of meeting new people, I liked the idea of collaboration, I liked the idea that it was all about the process and being able to take the time to really almost indulge in this creative meeting of different individuals who are not necessarily fashion designers, but fashion practitioners, as the way the festival described it.
It also related to my practice because I work a lot with fashion images and fashion imagery. So like how images are displayed online through brand advertisement and what does it mean to advertise a brand or a project. So I always have been interested to think about how to display fashion projects physically, like if you think of a store or a more artistic presentation, like more about like a fashion experience.
So FashionClash brought together really, I think, very interesting and diverse people from very different backgrounds. So I myself, I make clothes, you know, I do a lot of costume for dance and theatre and scenography work. But for example, there's Chinouk, who's a writer and a critical thinker, you know, in her practice. Enzo is more within a digital, has a more digital online internet graphic design focus. Boris is also a tailor, but more in a more, yeah, in a more conceptual art sort of perspective or practice, and Lotte is more into performance. What was nice was that the language of fashion kind of brought us together.
I think we also tried to understand each other's practice in a more professional language, like what do you work, like how do you approach fashion on a personal level regarding like sustainability, production method, process-wise, how do you find your concepts and intentions. So I think there was like a very personal level that we connected through everyday activities and a more like professional level that we had to discuss what fashion is for us, and just what is it to be a maker nowadays. And I think through those two lenses, we find a way to get a sense of each other's.
Yeah, what was really inspiring was actually the conversations that I was able to have with many of the other people of the team that were invited. Because it's not very often you suddenly get this opportunity to really sit down and spend time, you know, with a group of people who are interested in topics that you are into as well, and just really take the time to get to know one another in such a short, intense time frame, and really try to also work together as well. That was really fun. I think that was the most inspiring, actually.
I think the values of FashionClash were connected to also my intention as a maker, like this idea of a democratic approach to fashion that also makes fashion a subject to address to a broader audience than just fashion practitioners. I think that was like a match. And also, yeah, like the way the questionnaire was made, like very simple questions, straight to the point.
It's very exciting, obviously, because we for the first time gave something out of our hands. Normally, we select designers, we place them in locations, we create the context as well. And that's obviously, it's already exciting because you invite five people, they also don't know each other, they have to collaborate. So already that is a process which we think it's important way of giving out knowledge, kind of giving out, passing the knowledge that we have for many years. So when they came up with a concept, we rolled out an open call. A bunch of designers, quite a few designers applied, and together with them we made a selection. And there I think we gave them a lot of freedom, but we also were looking at the overall, that it fits with the FashionClash values, that you also want to have local designers, that it's a nice mix of people. And I think overall we come up to a really nice selection of work.
Well, I thought it was really nice because all of us, we basically, the group of us consists of five curators in total, mm-hmm. and each of us, in a way, selected participants that we really felt in a closer affinity with their work. And that really helped, I think, with the mm-hmm. process in actually trying to create or show their story or their process.
Well, so I feel like because we're all designers ourselves, like we have a sense of like curating our own show, or like our own practice as well, it also helps to like understand further another person's like story or like another practice.
The whole concept that they came up with, this whole idea of co-authorship, to show what is behind the process, that was actually very much in line with how we work at FashionClash as well. We also like to show the process. We also like to create a co-authorship and co-creation. And they, in a way, gave it back to us how we also work, but really framed it in a different way. I think it turned out very nice, and the experiment, it's something that's not going to be an experiment anymore. We're going to keep it as a part of how we work and see what other exciting projects will come out when you give people the playground to play, literally play around in a place like this.
Yeah, no, it really built up a sense of community and trust, I think, mm-hmm. with one another. That in the end, like, yeah, you know, I think it got us to a point where we felt so comfortable with one another, we could basically also say whatever we wanted without the fear of any kind of rejection or mm-hmm. judgment on one's ideas. I think that really helped also with this whole process,
yeah.
Right? I think that was really great. So no, thank you also so much, I think, to FashionClash for also putting your trust in us mm-hmm. as well, you know, and also to Bureau Europa for helping out as well, the city of Maastricht for really, you know, facilitating and, you know, contributing to this kind of cultural development within the province, mm-hmm. To also all the other participants as well, you know, for also taking the time to apply to this as well. It's also quite a process to apply. Yeah. You have to write text and put in your portfolio, and you're kind of bearing in a way your soul, your process, and for also being so open to feedback and on how to kind of display their work. I think mm-hmm. that's also that I'm really grateful and would like to thank all of them for that.
Yeah, I mean, thank you to FashionClash. Like, I think it was a nice, I think the residency was like a very precious moment, I feel like.
It was wonderful.
Like, I think like this first week we spent all together with FashionClash team and like the other, like all the curators together. Also at FashionClash, how do you call, office, was really like, yeah, a sweet memory and also very like precious to get to know each other.